So, today I'm going to talk to you guys a little bit about my experience learning how to do yoga. So, the objectives, you're going to be able to list two factors that motivated me to learn yoga. You'll be able to describe my learning process and identify what I think was the main barrier to my learning. And then you'll also be able to identify three discoveries about teaching that I learned throughout the process. Just to start with a quote, this actually is it was originally a Chinese proverb, and then I think it kind of got changed a little bit, and now it's attributed to Ben Franklin, but it says, "Tell me and I forget, teach me and I may remember, involve me and I learn." So I just want you to kind of keep that in the back of your mind as we go through this. So the reason that I wanted to learn yoga is because most of my life I was a gymnast, and so I was constantly in the gym. And then when I went to my undergrad, I joined a dance company, and I was dancing almost 4 hours a day in undergrad. And so I think that I was doing nursing school at the same time, but at least when I was dancing, it sort of gave me like a grounding part of my day, and it helped me relax, and I really felt that it was a really important part of helping me get through nursing school. And so when I graduated, you know, it's not that easy to find adult dance classes around. I was on the East Coast, but anywhere, adult dance just isn't really a thing. And so, you know, I kind of looked around and I didn't find anything. And then I started my nursing career, and I was so focused on nursing, and I thought, well, at some point I'll find something that gives me that same experience and that same relief. Sure, whatever. Well, 5 years later, 6 years later, 7 years later, no, didn't ever find anything besides food, you know. So then when we were presented with this project, I thought, well, I've always wanted to do yoga, but I don't think I've ever, you know, it kind of made me nervous, and I always thought, oh, I'm way too high energy for yoga. I'll never be able to sit in a yoga studio for an hour and, you know, do Zen things. That's just not me. And so I never really like had enough external motivation to do it. Nothing ever pushed me enough to get into the studio. And so I thought with this project, okay, time to, you know, try and do it. And so that was sort of that part of the motivation. And I also, in terms of picking yoga, you know, obviously there's a lot of physical benefits. So I think, you know, I have a lot of injuries from gymnastics, and when I danced, at least it helped with some of my, it kept me flexible and it kept my back from not hurting. I think it provided enough core strength that kind of kept everything feeling okay. And I think as I've gotten older, I feel like 20 years older than I am, more and more body parts hurt, and my back hurts, and my hips hurt, and my bursitis acts up, and I just, you know, I think dance kind of helped me manage that, and I had never really found anything else. So I thought, okay, yoga probably, that's what they talk about, yoga will help me. And then I thought, okay, well, people say that it's almost like meditation. It's going to help with sort of anxiety management. And so that was sort of my goal for choosing that. So when we first were assigned the project, I was like, okay, well, how am I going to find a place to go do yoga? I know that I'm not, when it comes to like something that I may be anxious about, I'm not an internal motivator. So going to YouTube, or going, you know, buying something at Target and doing it at home with videos was not gonna work for me. I knew that it would never happen. So I knew that I needed to find some kind of a studio where I could go and I would be forced to be in a class for an hour and have to do it. So I did some research, and I don't know, I was pretty nervous about the whole thing. I don't like going into new places. I don't like going to group exercise alone. You know, you don't have like, if you don't have a friend with you, you know, you're like, where do I sit? What if everyone's always there and I take someone's place? I mean, I just ruminate about all these ridiculous things. And so I didn't want to go to like a legit yoga studio, you know, because I thought, oh, you know, they'll be all advanced and I'm going to look like an idiot. So I thought, okay, I'll pick something more, you know, standard, a little more commonplace. So I picked Core Power Yoga because I thought, okay, well, there'll be a mix of people there. So I did all this research. I mean, they're not, you know, they don't only do yoga. They do a bunch of different classes. And so I spent a lot of time going through the classes and trying to think, okay, what can I do? And I read through all the descriptions. And I found like their basic yoga And I got everything ready, and it was the first week of the blog, and I wrote about it, and then I like got in the car, and then I was like, nah, I'm not gonna go. I was like, I'm not here, like I can't, nah. And I got out of the car and I went back inside. I was like, not today. So, you know, I kind of wrote about the fact that like I just couldn't get through the door. I was like, I don't know where I'm going, you know, I don't. So the thing is, my mom owned a personal fitness studio my whole life, so I never had to go to gyms. I didn't have to go to classes. I didn't have to like go to an awkward front desk and be like, hi, I'm here for this class. Like, where do I go? I just never had to do any of that. And I just, I don't know, I don't like doing new things. So it took me a long time. So I didn't get in the studio the first week. And then the next week, I was at work and Dina knows all every day at work. I was like, oh God, how am I gonna get in the studio? Like, what am I gonna do? Oh geez, this is not good.
Well, it's not meant to be a stressful activity.
Anything new is stressful for me, okay? It's not good. So I was like, what am I gonna do? So ironically, our patients, we have yoga on our inpatient unit for our patients. So we have a yoga instructor who's we've known for a long time, and she's really sweet, and her and I were talking, and she's like, oh, well, you know that there's, I do a little yoga class for the staff once a week, you know, down in the auditorium. So if you want to take your break and just like come down and see it, go ahead. And I was like, oh, okay, cool. I'm like, that's great, because it's in a place I know, and I'm familiar with the hospital, and I know her, and it's not going to be a bunch of yogis who like know what they're doing, you know. So I went down there for about 30 minutes, and that's kind of how I got my foot in the door, and I thought that was really, you know, having that comfortable environment was really great. So I, you know, how I learned first was having like a comfortable space and peers to help me. And then I felt better because at least I knew what the words were and I knew like I had some basis of what I was doing. So then the next week I was like, okay, I'm gonna go to the studio, I'm gonna do it. And I still kind of had like in my mind, like, eh, I'm not gonna do it, it's not gonna happen. And then, you know, I had a pretty difficult incident happen at work, and I was like really anxious and I was a mess, and I thought, okay, I need to get into somewhere where I'm going to just have an hour where I'm away from everything else. I need to force myself to do this. I'm not gonna make it if I don't just like do something to help myself. And so that got me in. I'll be honest, it wasn't me being like, I'm gonna go do it. It was like the last resort to, you know, keeping my sanity. So I went in, and it was just funny because I was so nervous going in the door, and everyone was so nice, and they were like welcoming, and you know, there was no issues, and I went into the studio, and then of course you find out that the Core Power 1 class is the same sequence no matter what. It's a structured class, no matter who teaches it, it's the same thing, you'll always know what to expect, you never have to, you know, worry about it being something different. And I was like, oh great, if I'd known that, I would have come a lot sooner. So I started in Core Power 1, and I did that about 3 times, and I really liked that it was structured. So I didn't have to worry about the next time coming, and what if it's a different teacher who does something different, and I don't know what I'm doing. So I knew what to expect, and I knew that even if I wasn't comfortable with the flow the first day, that I would be able to have a way of kind of pacing myself, and I'd have an expectation to rely upon to then go and do the next class. And so I did a couple of those, and I really liked it for kind of my beginning experience, because it really helped me feel comfortable going. And I think the other thing, just the instructors were really helpful. And so the instructors guided me, and I kind of told them, listen, I'm new, I don't know what I'm doing. You know, please kind of help me out if I look lost. And so as I've kind of talked about, obviously my barriers mainly was my anxiety, I'll be honest with you. I don't think time had anything to do with it. There was time, you know, I could have gone to yoga. There was time. I mean, I watched a lot of Netflix instead of going to yoga. So, time was not an issue, but my anxiety for sure was. You know, I had built this whole thing up in my head about how terrifying it was going to be, and everyone else was going to know how to do yoga, and I was going to look like a beached whale in the corner. It's just not good. So, that was really the main barrier that I identified. And I think, you know, interestingly, so I went through the process. I did like a couple weeks of just that standard class. And then, you know, I actually, my friend came in from town and she's a major yogi. So I said, okay, let's go. You're going to come with me. And we did the class together. And it was in that class that I sort of started to get bored. I was like, you know, half an hour through, I'm like, oh gosh, like, is this class over yet? Like, I'm done. You know, and so I really reflected on that, and I was like, okay, I actually think that maybe I'm ready for the next class. I think I can, you know, step out of the beginners and out of the comfort zone and try something else. So I looked up, I went back to the schedule, and I looked, and I was like, okay, I'll go do 1.5. Not two, that's too much of a step, 1.5. And so I, like, wasn't expecting anything much different. I walk in, and it's a heated studio. And I went, oh, no. Like, I thought I was just going to fall over, because that was, like, my biggest fear. I had done one yoga class in my whole life. It was, like, 5 years ago. It was, like, hot yoga, and I thought I was going to die the whole time. So I had built this up as, like, this horrible experience. And I walk in, and I was like, no, not eat. But I stayed. It wasn't that bad, and I think, you know, that was kind of the end of my experience, and I was glad that I had at least pushed myself through to that point, 1.5, woo-woo. But I got through, and I was much more comfortable. I don't think I would go back to it. I think I would stick with one, even though it's kind of boring, because the heat was just going to kill me. But, you know, I learned a lot through the process, even though I didn't really get that far in yoga. I really learned a lot. I think, you know, having a supportive environment for people is really important. You know, support of your peers is really important. Making sure that students know that, like, the classroom is a safe space so that those who are more anxious than others can feel comfortable is really key. What I really liked about the one instructor I had, because it was the same instructor the day I went, was that he was really good at setting the scene for the day. So he would, as we would start in child's pose, he would kind of give us something to guide our practice with, and he would... It was really helpful. He would be like, today we're going to worry about, you know, I want you to think about perspective, and he'd give a little spiel. And it would really help me kind of guide through, so when I started to drift or wander off or start to worry about school a week later, I would kind of bring myself back to what he had provided as a scene, and that kind of kept me present in the class. And then I think, you know, when I noticed that I was getting bored, obviously I knew at that point it was my time to move on, but I think when you're an instructor it's different, and I think if you can start to see that people are losing presence in front of you and in the class, it's important to be able to change things up and be flexible and maybe end it if it's just, you know, not gonna happen, you know. Yeah, and again, so just having variety of styles and activities. So I thought I learned a lot from it, even though it was a little more stressful than I anticipated getting started. I didn't put any pictures up because, so, and this is kind of what I liked, you know, they're very serious about, like, when you come into the studio, it's a safe space, no phones, no cameras, put everything away, just come in and it's only you and the studio. And so I really enjoyed that too, because it forced me to just, like, disconnect from everything. When I went in the studio, it was just me and the studio, not anything else, so. That was my experience. Any questions?